Are you getting used to people recognising you in the street? Because the show has been so successful.
Yes, actually, it is. I've noticed I've been asked to autograph and to have some pictures taken.
Yeah.
Yes.
And how is that? Is that strange, people coming up to you like that?
It is, in a way. Because I never expected all this kind of like fame, because I'm not really used to it, but it's just amazing. Just, you know, people screaming our names, it's just unbelievable.
And you guys met on the show. Did you actually expect to find love? How was that?
Well, it all started off as a blind date at first. Then all of a sudden it ended on the undateables. And I guess that's where it all started. Yeah.
And how about you?
It was just a bit of a dream, really. I mean, if it wasn't for my friend to get me into the undateables, I wouldn't have done it. But I actually thanked him, and I really loved it, and a chance to meet Simon, he's amazing.
So you weren't going to do the show until one of your friends sort of encouraged you to?
Well, it was part of a summer ball that I went to. I didn't notice that the TV crew were there, and then I put my name across because my friend sort of said, they're here, and I couldn't have put my name forward, and all this happened, so...
And this is a film about romance, admittedly not a conventional one. A guy who's got two wives.
Yeah.
How would you guys deal with that situation?
Well, to have that, it would be very, it wouldn't be very nice, that's for sure.
It'd be stressful.
Yeah. And it'd be very, I don't know how to say it, but I'd just say it's just not very nice to cheat on your wife.
Yeah.
And Valentine's Day coming up as well, guys. A lot of pressure, especially for you, Simon. What have you got planned for Kate?
Well, I was thinking about going bowling. And then after that, we'll go for a meal.
Does that sound good to you, Kate?
It does to me, yeah. Sounds very romantic.
Well, guys, it's very cold. I'll let you go. Enjoy yourselves tonight. Thank you.